Lol.
How you doing?
Hello, I'm fine, thank you, and you?
I'm good, I'm good. Sorry, I'm running a little bit late.
No, it's totally fine. It's okay.
How's your week been?
Oh, so far so good.
All right. Well, I had a decent StarCraft week at least. I was away for work for a few days, so I didn't get to play as much as I wanted to, but I used that plan that we spoke about last week of playing one custom game and just focusing on the build and then playing one multiplayer game after that. So I didn't get to do it every day, but I did it 5 times this week and I got 4 wins out of 5, which is pretty decent.
That's good,
And
yeah.
yeah, and I'm up to tier 1 in Silver League now from tier 2. So next stop, gold.
Ha, awesome. I like that.
Yes. So I don't know, you want to watch a couple of replays and see what's going good and what's going bad?
Sounds good to me.
Let's see if I can fire one up then. It's a little bit of a mixed bag this week.
Okay, that's fine.
I must be getting close to gold because certainly when I look at the ladder that it's put me in, all the people around me, above and below, seem to be gold. So I can't be far away now.
Let's see. Yeah, true. Not too far away, at least.
Well, when I looked last time, it was like two places in front of me was gold. So I thought, geez,
At least gold is not too far off from you, so yeah. Ah, okay. I am already host, didn't know
Sorry.
that.
So I can't remember which ones I won and lost here, so we'll have to wait and see. Because some of these were a few days ago now.
Okay, so let's just have a look there. Is it working with the custom games before going into ladder for you, or?
Yeah, it's good because I get flustered a bit when you're trying to do a build order during a game when when you're getting harassed and that kind of thing. It throws me off pretty easily.
Mm-hmm.
So playing the custom game first, you know, the computer's pretty standard in the way it does everything. So let's just focus on trying to get the build order right. So it's actually been really good.
Okay, that's good to hear. Is this really closed?
Sorry?
The wall you're setting up, I'm not sure if it's closed. I don't know, actually.
It might not be.
I don't know. It seems a little bit... It seems like you could sneak through a probe, but I'm not certain here.
Yeah.
I'm not quite sure. Okay, so there is...
SimCity still never quite as good as I want it to be.
Oh, exactly with this... Exactly with this gate, that's... okay. Because the second gate is right in front of your...
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah.
So I'm trying to make a Reaper wall, but I've blocked my own bloody probes.
Yeah, what you can do is, if you... I mean, the Reaper hole is nice. I still think you could sneak through a probe between the pylon and the gateway there.
I think you're right.
If the pylon would be one more right to the gas geyser and one up, I think then it would be closed.
Yes. Yeah.
And maybe the second gateway. Maybe you could have put it a little bit
to the right.
Yes. And then wall off with another pylon and the core, maybe, or something like that. Later on, you don't need to have the wall up right now, because as you can see, his barracks is not even finished yet.
Yeah.
So you have the time to wall off, because your buildings don't need to be finished; they just need to be produced when the Reaper arrives. So the timing still should be fine. Yes, because in this instance you are blocking your gas income by quite a bit, to be honest. Especially if you would have put the core right there.
For
yeah.
The rest of the whole game, my economy is not real great from memory.
And yes.
I stuffed up with my probe. Normally I try to steal his gas if the second gas isn't taken. So I'm
okay.
My probe killed then instead.
Mm. Okay. So he's playing a little bit different here. Okay. Where's your probe? Did it die?
I lost my probe scouting, yeah, in his mineral line.
Oh, okay. How did that happen?
I was just lazy.
Okay.
So it was going through the mineral line instead of around the back of it, so we just got trapped and killed. See, instead of stealing the gas, I just got stuck there.
Ah, okay. Let's rewatch this. I want to see where you are looking at. Okay. So you are right here. Du-du-du-du-du. Probes are under attack. Building that. Okay, so you see it.
Yep.
But
I just reacted too late.
Yes. What you can do if you got the time. You can use the minimap as we discussed, I think, last time.
Yep.
But the probes, SCVs, and drones have a little trick you can use.
I should have just right-clicked on a mineral patch.
Yes.
And then it just passes.
Exactly. There, so if you
heat a battle, my brain doesn't work as
yes.
It should.
That's why I could recommend to you, if you have the time, sending out the probe. Let's see what you have to do when you send out the probe, because maybe that's possible for you, if you don't have to do anything. Okay, so right now there is... you're getting the gases, I think.
No. So that probe's already on the way?
Yes.
So then I normally get the gases after the first gate.
Yes, exactly. So, but now you got time.
Yeah.
So, what you could do is you could click on the probe again. And instead of having it clicked like you did, here and there, you could right-click with the shift command on the most outer mineral patches in his main base, and then on one mineral patch in his natural, which you almost did. So it should, unless he pulls all the worker, then you need to react fast. But whenever the probe enters the base, you should also watch it. So in the ideal situation, but still it should give you the opportunity so that it passes through anything on its own potentially. And rescues itself on its own. In this case, it was only one SCV blocking and attacking it, so it would have had the time. You can try it out, maybe it helps. Having this probe killed is not the worst that can happen to you, but having it not killed is of course better, because you can get the proxy pylon for later on, in the case he does this this wall and this if he sieges you and pins you back into your natural with tanks and liberators, then it's also always good to have this probe and have the pylon there for later on. And you can later on go in and scout again at 2:30 or 3 minutes or whatever it was. So yes, having it on the mineral patches is always good. Okay. Yeah, there it dies. He has so many minerals. Okay, so you still are not getting the salad here with your double gateway against Terran.
No.
I still think you could do this. Especially if you play the robotics facility. For now, you are really one basing him.
So, where there's a Reaper path like there is in this map, though, if you make a Zealot, isn't that almost wasted if he puts a Reaper against you because it's so slow?
The Reaper can definitely kill the Zealot if it gets microed correctly. That's true. But you have possibilities to potentially it goes there. Yes. Here's the Reaper, and you go the way your probe did. So you see what's highlighted and what's not. And on most maps you have side blockers like there or maybe there, especially there. So if he sees the Zealot and wants to kill it, you can always hide it there on the side blocker. So the Reaper needs to come close to kill or attack the Zealot. If it does, the Zealot might attack it, especially because you are in Silver League, where they will bank up 1,000 minerals, and then the Zealot paid for itself already, because they are not spending their money, but try to kill a Zealot which does nothing to them. Instant win on that part. Also, if you can keep the Zealot alive long enough to your Stalker to show up, you can potentially kill the Reaper if you didn't already. Yes. If you can save the Zealot, which you should be able to do so, you then have one Zealot and two Stalker against whatever he got, and that's most likely a Reaper and two Marines on the way out, which is not enough to kill two Stalker at all. So you can siege his ramp, kill this SCV mining at the natural, attack his command center and so on. So I would always get it, especially in PvP. It's very important to have this Zealot, which we already had in a previous episode of this coaching. Okay, so you're still one basing him. Okay.
So this dude just does from memory, I think he just plays with he just spams me with Marines and Marauders, but I've scouted him here at least, which is good.
Yes.
And I think my economy is just pretty good, so I think this is one of the ones I win.
Yeah, so your economy actually, if you would play a gateway into Nexus instead of the double gateway robo facility, you could now be on like 60 probes or even more instead of the 37 you have. I understand. Okay, here he comes. Here he moves out. I do understand that this build gives you the feeling of being safe. However, if you are climbing the ladder at some point, also you still have this going on where you have one pylon for four buildings.
Yep.
Would have been better the gateways to be somewhere there or maybe back there, somewhere else. Yes. If you as soon as you're climbing the ladder at some point, with the kind of build you play, you will need to be active with your stalkers and chip away as many units as possible while behind expanding, which will put a lot of pressure onto your multitasking. So at some point with this kind of stuff you're playing right now, you will face the problematics of either improve your multitasking, or you need to switch builds to be still efficient to something more economic focused. Just that you know that at some point you will need to change what you are doing right now or improve it, one of those. For now it's still fine, but as soon as you will hit gold 1, platinum, then it's getting really rough, because those players won't forget their mules that often in the early game. They will have more refined build orders and they will hit you with better timings, probably, or just out macro you, and then you are far behind. But for now it's fine, you are up 15 workers, so absolutely okay. So he has Stim.
Shield batteries there.
Yeah, that's awesome.
I've got the extended. Oh no, no thermal lance yet. Okay.
Yeah, you are just now getting the gases. He is just now stimming, and you can clear this easily.
Yeah. And he didn't rally his army very well.
True. Yeah. Now the gas hits you a little bit. Also, we have the minerals for another base. It's good that you didn't take it. I think, however, he would not have even scouted it. So if you would have had a Nexus building right there, right now, it would be totally good for you.
Yep.
Still,
I do take it now.
I
might have, whenever I think he's about to send his army over, I normally go, no, just wait and see if I can hold and then drop the base. So hopefully I drop a base in the next 30 seconds.
Okay. What you also can do, which we discussed last time, was you could get one sentry.
Yes.
Against Zerg, we were talking about this. Against Terran, it's possible as well. Where is your observer currently? Oh, it's following. What?
I got it to follow the army back, so I
okay.
able to keep it tags
okay.
on where it was at.
You also have only one observer at all. So in this case, you did scout his main base. I don't know how far it was away. If he would go for dropships like medivacs, then you definitely would like to have more observers scattered around your base. One with your army and at least one at his ramp or at his barracks production somewhere there. Following his army is good, but it also limits your vision, so you don't know what he's doing behind this. So it's a double-edged sword. If you know where his army is, that's awesome. So whenever you do this kind of stuff with the observer, depending on where the game goes, and if you play a more economic-focused opening, you probably would have more observer. What you could do then, just theorizing here, is have this one observer with his army, but send one from your main base, or maybe the one of your army, back to his base, so that you exchange those. As soon as his army reaches your army, you still have detection because your observer from his base followed his army to your army, and you get to see what he's doing behind that. So if you have more observer and he moves out and you click your observer from one of his army, units, you can send one of your observer from your army to a space, so you have constant vision. That would work. It's a little bit complicated, but I think later on, if you climb the ladder, it's something that could help you. Yes, in this game I don't see him dropping anything, like he's just moving out. What I wanted to... Yes.
Sorry, you go ahead.
What I wanted to initially say is get sentries. Not many, but two or three, so you have the Hallucinated Phoenix and the Guardian Shield. Just imagine you take this fight and you have the shield batteries absorbing three shields per energy, restoring them, so that's good. But if you would have the sentry with the Guardian Shield, you would take even less damage. Especially if he moves in like that one by one. So that's absolutely bad on his side. You lose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stalker, 6, 7, 8 stalker. I think I counted correctly. Yes, awesome. With the shield battery, maybe it would have been way less because his marines almost lose half their damage. If you have the Guardian Shield, let's see. His upgrades are plus 1 on attack, 7 damage. No, it's not that much. But 2 damage gets taken away. Okay, doing math is difficult, but you can lower the damage output by a lot, especially on units that fire fast and deal slow small chunks of damage in fast pace. So Guardian Shield always good to have against Terran. It would have saved a lot of Stalker lives in this situation, I think. You're still ahead, so it's fine. But you could... I'm always trying to be more efficient. You could be in an even better situation right now. I like that you are not putting the fortress next to the gateways and the robotics. So that's good. Sprinkle around a little bit. Okay. And now you see the problem with the economy you currently have. The two-base economy with the double fortress and the robotics facility is barely enough to keep your facilities working.
Yep.
So if you that's the thing, if you don't expand early enough, you will run into this problem where you have to make this decision to not produce anything but a nexus, and that will definitely cost you a lot of time in your build, because as you can see, you now can sometimes warp in some stalker, and that's it. You don't have much, especially if you want to go for 2-2, you need that third base. So it's just now getting there. You have the observer back, I love that, that's really important. Most people will forget about this, but you didn't, so kudos to you, that's really good.
Better at my scouting.
Yes, that's really important. So he's taking now a base, as well as you do. At some point, you should run your observer in again to see what he's getting. Now you don't know. He could potentially have gotten some factories, or maybe he plays suddenly Mass Liberator. It could happen that he throws down 3 starports, not with the build he got, because he still doesn't have the gases taken. So if you scout that, you don't need to worry. But if you would have, then at some point going in again and see what his production facilities are could be important. Okay. Okay, so your base finishes up. I hope you are resaturating soon. You are not. Slowly. Okay. So you're both just muckering up. You see his amount of bio units, which is a lot.
Yeah, it's out of control, isn't it?
It seems like it is, yes.
So I think because I saw he had Marauders, so I've chucked a few more Immortals in.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I've started some charge lots as well from memory. Yes.
Yes. I like that you now have the sentries. That's good.
Yeah, so I did remember to do those. And I think I do even send a hallucinated phoenix over, but my micro's not very good. So from memory, I lose it. And I've made a couple of DTs that I've started hiding around the place too.
Ah, I see.
So I've got one hidden behind his next expansion, and I've got another one hidden near his third base.
Yes.
I think I send in to annoy him every now and then.
I see. You always at some point can scatter around one or two pylons on the map. It never hurts to have that. So whenever, for example, right now, it is late, to be honest, but you could do it. You are also banking up a lot of minerals now. So on how many gateways you are on?
Not enough.
10. It's okay. 4 are not unfold, but it's okay. Maybe you could throw down a second robotics facility, but that's optional.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
You get double Stargate, so that's there. There is your transition. So fine. It's okay. And he moves out. You did see it. Where is your observer again? I think it's with the army.
I think it's.
Oh! It got killed? No, wait.
Might have lost it. Yeah, he must have scanned. Yep, he's killed it.
I want to see that. So there it is. Okay. Yeah, he scanned it. Okay. He only sends his marauder out. What is he doing?
I think he stuffed up. He just must have miskeyed.
So okay.
I don't think he rallies his troops real well.
He's definitely attacking now. And that's a lot of stuff he got there.
Yeah, and I've got good upgrades by now too.
He definitely can't kill you. It's.
No.
I don't see him winning disengage coming.
No.
He's not even stimming. Now. He gets a good concave, however.
He did pretty good. I was a little bit worried here for a second.
Yeah.
But he didn't keep his troops together either, so...
Yes. That's why you won this fight. And then he just taps out. Actually, this disengage could have gotten really wrong for you.
Yeah, I didn't... Yeah, you're right. He got a really good concave going. And I probably should have stepped back a little bit earlier than what I did. See, it was okay here for me, but then when he bought these other troops,
yeah.
The
so one thing is, you have lots of troops at your Colossus, which are not attacking at all. They are just derping around because they don't get to the enemy. And 3 Colossus is not much against this amount of units he has. So. It's a little bit difficult. I like that you have the Guardian Shield. That's very important. Otherwise, you would have lost way more. Ah, yeah. Instead of moving up to him now, that's the problem. When you attacked, and he attacks you and you go in, so here it's fine. Okay? Here you should go in because he's clumped up. That heavily that you have the splash damage. So right now you should go in as deep as you can with your zealots and everything that everything can shoot. But as soon as your zealots die, that's where you should pull back now. You should pull back now to the top so that he funneled through this nexus you got and this weird cliff thingy building. So that you get that you have this bottleneck where he needs to funnel through, and there is where you strike. Especially if you cut his army in half. Now you have the sentries, they have still energy, you could use force fields. So lure him in, cut his army in half, kill it, and then kill the rest. And you would have lost way less units by doing so. Because now you move into his concave, and that's where he can shred you. Now you pull back. But he gets on the right hand side, so force fields are not an option anymore. Yes, but he doesn't follow you. If he would have followed you, potentially it could have been closer.
some high Templars there with some storms.
Ooh, that definitely would have killed him. If when his army was there and you throw up three storms, he taps out immediately. He can't win this anymore. That would have been instant win for you. Yes, so normally when you if you would play economic building build order, you would do the transition of the second. It depends a little bit, but maybe at minute 8 or 9 you can go for the second splash type. Maybe minute 10. It really depends on how the game goes. But it sometimes it's possible to fake your enemy out. If you, for example, go for a Colossus and you just go for one, and then you switch into Storms and he gets Vikings, and his Vikings are completely useless because you have High Templar and he doesn't have Storm, Ghost to EMP. And those Vikings don't do anything good against Stalker, they are okay, but against Zealots? Definitely not. So you could experiment with that. At some point, at least at some point get the High Templar, I would say, for the Storm. But yeah, it's...
Normally when I try to switch to Zealot Archon, I normally do build the Templar Archives rather than the Dark Shrine. I'm not sure why I did the Dark Shrine in that game.
It's always good. If you have the money, do it. Most people forget about it, or they can't fit it into their build, but if it's getting later in the game, definitely go for the Dark Shrine. I hate Dark Shrine because it's very powerful, but that's what it's for, so go for it. Especially that's so nice. Especially if he moves out and you see it, and then you have this proxy pylon which you didn't have in this game, but if you had, and then you warp in DTs and Zealots. I would really go for a combination of stuff there. Some Zealots, some DTs. So maybe he doesn't see the DTs. He just sees the Zealots, goes in with his army, trades, but then the DT is left over and kills everything. Especially in your league currently. Most people won't recognize the Dark Templar at all. So you can get an additional benefit there.
I'm happy to lose that probe because I at least got his gas first.
It's always annoying to lose the gas. You also see quite a bit of his base. It's not bad.
That was a bit of scout. I've been watching a lot of a YouTube streamer named Zuka, who's a French bloke, and he plays Protoss. And he always loves it when he gets to steal someone's gas. So
yes.
I've been stealing that from him because he thinks it's bloody awesome whenever you can do it.
What you normally do with the gas steal, I think, is you do it either to annoy your opponent, which you definitely do. But if you play a more aggressive opening, it can actually deal a lot of damage because your opponent won't be able to get tanks and Vikings or Liberator out of his production facilities. So if you go for the gas and you get it and you tend to choose a more aggressive opening, then you can actually deal lots of damage to him. So you see those. What you also could do, but it costs a lot of, at least a little bit of practice. If you have the Stalker and you want to see up the ramp, you could have one adept and shade up so that the shade grants you high ground vision, and then you can attack the supply depots or maybe the marines or potentially whatever you got. So that would be an option. But this time you're getting the Nexus, I think, earlier. I'm not quite sure.
This is a much better.
Yes, I think so.
And I keep getting dropped and beaten by Terran, so I dropped the shield battery.
Yes, you just forgot your observer. It's right on top of your robotics.
No, I made it, but I didn't move it. Yeah,
no, and you will never see it because it's almost stealthed for yourself. If you look at your robotics right now, You can't see it yourself. It's impossible. It's so stealth. Wow. That's the worst observer ever.
It's
Okay, that's I never thought you could hide your observer to yourself by putting it on top of the sphere of the robotics facility. That's interesting. Now you move it. Okay, you found it. Awesome. Okay, that's good. So he scans you.
Normally that observer is the first thing that comes out of my
yes.
robo every time, so...
It also should.
Normally, yeah, see I've left it at my base here. Okay, now I've set it out.
Yes, now you have two.
I was frightened of this guy and I've dropped shield batteries everywhere and I don't know why.
Yeah, you were frightened because you didn't scout and you had no idea what was coming or not. That's the thing. Having shield batteries is not bad, but if you get your scouting a little bit better on, right now you go in.
I think I do one here and I see that he's gone.
Mech, yeah. So if you see him going mech, the best thing or one thing you could definitely do is you immediately stop any Colossus production, because Colossus lose so hard against mech, they just get wrecked. Stalker can work if you have good blink micro and be super active against this force. Like if he moves out and you have your stalker, like, and then you go in killer tank blink out and he sieges up and needs to siege down again, and then he moves further, you kill another tank, blink out, be super active, and if he goes to your base, you cycle around with your stalker to hit one of his bases and attack there and force him to go all in. Then you can go to stalker if you are super active with them, which I don't think you have the multitasking quite yet. So if you see him going mech, fortress, perfect, but throw down one, maybe even two facilities, robotics, maybe. If you have the maybe three would be overkill, but two is definitely possible. Definitely, at minimum two, maybe three if you have the economy for it, but then you need three or four bases to supplement it. And just crank out a lot of Immortal. Like, you can go up to 10 or 12, maybe even 14. 14 is a little bit much, but 10 to 12 is fine, and get charge slots with lots of upgrades. And get like 30 charge slots. Of course, you shouldn't run them into a bunch of Widow Mines. So they need to be a little bit careful. For splash damage, Storm can work as well. If you can afford it, you can go into Storm. I would just think it's better to go Salad, Archon, Immortal. So charge slot, Archon, Immortal. You don't need Storm, you can do it. It's a nice supportive damage tool for you. It won't kill much, but it's damage because mech is slow and clumps up as well. Yeah, but definitely don't go for Stalker if you aren't active with them, and definitely don't go for Colossus. They will die to tanks. Like, a tank deals 70 damage to one Colossus, so a Colossus dies to 5 or 6 tank shots, and if he goes mech, he probably has 16 tanks, I don't know. So they just they die. They don't have the range, they don't add anything to your army. Okay. So he scans again. That's nice for him. So now you go into Immortal, that's good. Upgrades, that's nice. Again, I'm pointing out you have one pylon powering 5 buildings. Okay, this opponent is definitely a little bit stronger than the last one you got. You showed me. But I don't agree with him moving out, because this little force won't do anything. Yes, it's helpful. That's right. I also do it as Terran. I have if I think about it, I have supply depots scattered around my base as spotters. Later on in the game, they don't cost much, and I see a lot of stuff. And the best thing is, you don't ruin your own vision whenever you press all army hotkey, because buildings don't move normally. Oh yeah, that pylon is important. So you killed that off. So you still can work a lot of your of or on your macro. As you see, we are now at the okay. You could go in a little bit more there. We are now scratching the 10-minute mark. Yes, where you could slowly be on 180 supply with 2-2 on the way, or at least halfway done. Oh. Okay, I know it's annoying, but I have to point it out. That pylon, man, it's not healthy. It's not good for you. At one point, there will be Terrans who tend to drop you, and if they take out that pylon, unpowering 6 of your gateways. Ouch! Yes. Because that could be 6 charge slots with potentially 3-3 upgrades, which you don't have at any fight. That's the thing. But okay, the game currently is a little bit slowing down. Oh, what you also can do against mech, so now you know you go into Archon, Charge Lord, Immortal, which is exactly what you should have done earlier. Before getting the... So, the first Colossus, maybe yes, depending on when you scout, it's fine. Because you don't want to cancel it. I wouldn't really cancel it if it's mech. Having it is okay. The second one was too much. And the Blink Stalk, as I said, you don't even have Blink, so they will just die to any tank fire. But what you can do, especially if you have the second Robotics, and if you go Charge Lord Archon, against mech, you want to utilize the ability of your Warp Prism play. So, maybe have a pylon there, but Warp Prism is even better. If you have, especially later on in the game, if he moves out with your mech army, with his mech army, and you see it, I don't know where the observer is, it's at home, okay.
So I've kept one at home.
Yes.
I did have one at his base, but it just got killed.
So what you can do is have one warp prism, and at any point when he moves out, you wait 10 seconds, maybe 5 seconds, depending on where he is, but here, if you would see his move out right now, for example here, and you wait 5 seconds and then you move in with a warp prism, right on top of his production, always go on top of his production, so that you can kill any Thor, siege tank, Widowmine, whatever comes out, always drop on top of the production, maybe between those 3 factories down there, and then you just warp in all Zealots you can, like 10, 12, doesn't matter. Yeah, you would have the money for doing this. Perfect. You would have the money, and what you want... So I want to do 2 things. Move in, warp in that stuff, but combine it with your army attacking one of his bases. Potentially now here, his 3rd base. So then he needs to split his army and the last thing any mech Terran wants to do is split his army, because mech is only strong if combined. And then you would tear him apart. So now you see it, he scans it, but you know it's out, and you can prepare yourself. You could get a nice concave on the ramp, so you could set up one half of your army there, one half of your army there, potentially. He splits his army, which I don't agree with at all. Okay. Oh, and if you know he's coming, what you should try to do is your Zealots should always be on front. If they are behind your Stalker, they will not tank for your army and they won't deal any damage. So try to have them always at the front of your army.
What's the best way for me to control them?
Right now it's too late, actually. I mean, it's not too late. You still could pull back all your army, but not the Zealots. If you are, you saw him moving out. So sadly, you don't know where exactly he is, but you can anticipate him coming from this side, right? From the left side. So what you can do is just double click your Zealots. It will select all of them. You can also control and left click them, which works as well, to just select all Zealots you currently see on your screen, and then just right click left to your army so that they move there, and then they are at the front. Just double click one Zealot, left click, no, right click to the left of your army, in this case that's how it is, and then they move there, and that would be what you needed. Because as you can see right now, they can't get through. You will win this fight because he doesn't have much. Now your Zealots get through, but those are so important for tanking for your Immortal and dealing damage. They need to get to your opponent. But now I think you just win this game from there. He lost all of his army. His upgrades are not bad, so that's nice. But he definitely can't hold this. He get Marines for some reason. And you just crush him. Yeah. Yeah, that's game. Okay, it's not too bad. So you still can do a lot with your macro and your economy. There is still a lot of improvement you can do, but you will get to it if you just practice more with the custom games and try to focus to max out as soon as possible with 2-2. That's still your main goal. And I think at some point I gave you the notes. I hope you still have those. Yes. Where you have the benchmarks and try to hit them. Do you use the salt mod melee stuff?
I haven't used it in the last week, so I did use it before that, and it was pretty good, but I've been trying to not use it too much and just play the custom game before.
Okay.
I play a multiplayer.
Okay. Fair enough.
Well, I think we're almost out of time, aren't we?
No, we have still time for getting over one replay. Yeah. But I hope that was the time you played it and not the length of the game.
Sorry?
It said one... yeah, how long is it? Okay, it's 10 minutes. Because, so you played it on the in the night. I was like, I hope this game doesn't go 1 hour and 36 minutes.
No. I'd be GGing out if it goes so long.
Oh, against Protoss? Do you want to wall off against Protoss?
I normally do wall off out at the front there.
Yeah. I think you don't need to wall off against Protoss. No. You would need to watch one PvP pro game, or maybe one or two, maybe Zest or Showtime or Stats or whoever you want. Doesn't matter, there are lots of Protoss professionals out there. Just to see where they place their buildings in PvP. But I don't think they wall off against each other. No. I don't think so. So against Protoss, I don't think you need a wall.
Wall off against Zerg and Protoss, but not Terran. So
yeah. So against Terran, you get the Reaper wall. Against Zerg, you get the main base wall and the natural wall. So you again could get this Zealot, which you don't this time, but okay. Nice spendings on your Chrono Boost, that's nice. One Nexus there. So your Nexus is earlier, that's good.
Yeah, it's still pretty slow though.
Oh, he goes for double Stargate.
And I
I hope you do.
So Void Rays. So I've been getting a lot of Terrans playing a shit ton of Void Rays. What should I be countering Void Rays with? Is it just Blink Stalkers?
Blink Stalker can work. Void Rays are, however, good against armored units, which Blink Stalker are. I think what you could do if you scouted early enough, which in this case you don't.
I did just scouting.
Yes, but it takes you a lot of time. Ah, there it is. Ah, you scouted. Okay. Then you could just go. I think. I would need to think about that. And
what about Archons?
They definitely can work. I was thinking about Phoenix with the range upgrade. Because Phoenix, Void Rays don't deal much damage. Phoenix don't deal much damage to Void Rays either, but they attack faster, they are more mobile. And I think with the range upgrade you can outrange them a little bit. I never see Void Rays in PvP, so there's a reason for that. And potentially it's because Phoenix are just better with the upgrade.
Is that upgrade, do you need the fleet beacon to get that
upgrade? Yes, yes. But normally if you play air toss, sky toss, you get it anyway, so.
So I've dropped some cannons and stuff here.
Yeah. So Blink Stalker can definitely work, but you need good focus fire and good blink and a lot of Stalker there. And that's why you don't wall off against Protoss, yeah.
I almost lost this game because of that wall, I think.
Yes.
Might be the game I lose. Yeah.
Yes, that's the game you lose.
Yeah, so I saw it coming, but I just didn't count it quickly enough or well enough.
Yeah, I see. That's unfortunate, but I will try out this with. I will try this out. Yeah, that's game for you. I think Phoenix with range can work. You never see Void Rays in PvP unless it's some kind of all-in.
Yeah.
So they are not the best unit in PvP.
Yeah, so I probably just should have the wall stuffed me then.
Yeah, no wall and get blink. Then if you blink and get the focus fire on, then you can win against the Void Rays. Blink and focus fire them.
I started blink too late because you can see my blink's just about to finish.
Yeah,
it's already dead.
That's the sad part. But it's
so,
not looking too bad. I think if you continue and work on your macro
and the good thing is I saw it coming. So that's better than where I was at a couple of weeks ago. Where that
definitely
happened,
yes.
No,
you always. Yes, you always will encounter stuff which you scout but can't read into that. But that's. Fine, you can't know everything quite yet, so we can talk about that anytime you encounter something new and get a strategy out there to help you win this.
Terrific. Good stuff. All right. Well, mate, thank you very much for that, and I'll book you in for next week, hey?
Awesome. I'm looking forward to it, and maybe then you are gold. That would be awesome.
I hope so, mate. You have a good week, Alex. Cheers,
yeah,
mate.
You too. Bye. Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions, put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care, bye bye. Thank you.